even in the Bible. The Bible says they gather together and they pray. Let's bless the name of the Lord. Bless him. We will not forget the benefit. Times like this where systems have failed. Let's say, Father, we thank you. We thank you for who you are, because you are the same yesterday. You are the same today. You are the same forevermore. Let's bless him. Let's worship him. Let's exalt his holy name. The Bible says where two or three of us are gathered in his name. He is there in our midst. He is there here. He is there in every home that is represented. Let's just bless him. Let's say, Father, we are grateful. We exalt you. We worship you. We lift you high, for there is no one that is like unto you. Let's bless him. Let's bless his holy name. Let's honor him. Let's say, Father, we are grateful. We give you all the glory. We give you all the adoration. Be thou exalted, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have worshipped.
Amen.
Brethren, open your Bible with me to the book of Psalm 91. And I'm just going to read verse 1. This is a very popular verse that we all know. But as we are praying, as we're standing in the gap as walkers this morning, I want us to pray. It says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I want us to be in agreement this morning. I pray for every member of chapel that we cover every family with a blanket of joy. We cover every family and we put them under the blanket of joy. That in the name of Jesus, because it is written that he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Let's pray for God's divine protection. Let's pray that in all these things, only the counsel of God is time. God is taking us somewhere. God is teaching us something. Brethren, let's just say, Father, we thank you. Let's pray for every member of the church. Let's declare this service open. Let's ask that the name of God alone will be glorified in this place. Let's lift up every member of chapter. It's time for them to begin to enjoy. As many that have fasted in this church, as many that have called upon the name of the Lord, even our prayers shall not be wasted. I told us, I said, this is the time to shift our gaze on God and put it on him only. Never shift your gaze on the system. Never shift your gaze on any man. But this is the time to fix your gaze. Fix your gaze onto Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith, the one who is able to do, the one who is able to kill and to make alive. Let's just pray, say, Father, we are depending upon you. Shall we begin to pray, brethren? Let's begin to pray. Let's begin to pray. Let's begin to pray, because no evil will come near our dwelling place. Let's exalt the King of glory. Let's say, Father, we thank you that we are alive. As you are waking up this morning, somebody somewhere is giving up the ghost. But by the grace of God, because you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, God is not going to play with your life. The enemy cannot mess you up. Let's begin to thank God that we are alive. Let's exalt the King of glory. Let's worship him. Let's lift him high. The best is yet to come, and I know that the blessing of God is for us today. Let's give God praise. Don't allow the enemy to steal your joy. Thank you, the King of glory. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
The Bible says in 1 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14, that if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and repent of their sins, that I will heal their land. As workers this morning, I want us to ask God. I want us to ask God. God has revealed everything happening right now. He has revealed it before. And I want you to be at peace. By the grace of God, it shall be well. I want you to know that in the name of Jesus, as long as you belong to RCCG Chapel de la Resurrection, no plague, no illness, no sickness will come near you. And so as workers, we want to stand in the gap for the land. We want to stand in the gap for the land and the province, especially of Quebec. Because God is not a man that he should lie. Neither is he the son of man that he should repent. The Bible says, as he said it, and will he not do it? As he spoken, and will he not make it to pass? Let's pray for this land. And say, Father, please have mercy. Have mercy upon this land. Have mercy upon this land. Let's pray for divine intervention right now. Brethren, the whole world needs divine intervention. Let's pray for divine intervention. I say, oh God, this morning we have come to you again. Please intervene in the affairs of our land. Intervene in the affairs of the nations. Let's pray, brethren. Let's talk to God. Our God will intervene in the affairs of the nations. That God will intervene in the affairs of the nations. He is the Almighty. There is nothing that is too difficult for him. There is nothing that he cannot do. The Bible says he's not a man that he should lie. Neither is he the son of man that he should repent. As he said it, we need not do it. As he spoken, we need not make it to pass. Let us pray and ask God and say, in the mighty name of Jesus, we are in agreement this morning. We are standing in the gap for our nation. We are standing in the gap for other nations. We repent of our sins, O God. Sins of corruption, sins of immorality, sins of things that cannot even be said, sins of witchcraft, sins of idolatry, we repent of it this day, sins of dishonesty. Father, please have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon our nation. Have mercy upon our nation. Heal our land, O God. Heal our land, heal our land, heal our land, heal our land. We ask for divine intervention, O God, and let your name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Yes. Finally, I want us to pray for this morning's service. This morning's service, it's so wonderful to be in the presence of God, wherever you are watching. I want us to pray for this morning service. That God will do what only He can do. I want us to pray for this morning service. This morning service, we hunger for the grace of the Most High God, that God will quench our thirst. Let's pray for this morning service. This morning service, that God will go ahead of us, that the Lord will do what only He can do. Let's pray for this morning service, that we will have a reason to shout hallelujah. Let's pray for this morning service. That God will give us victory. Victory spiritual, victory physical, victory mental, victory marital. I want you to begin to pray and say concerning today's service, no one will remain the same. As many that will be watching online, as many that will come here, that today's service, Father, we ask in the name of Jesus, give us victory. Make us to be more than conquerors. Let's pray that God will make us to be more than conquerors. Father, make me a conqueror. Make me more than conquerors in everything that is happening in my vicinity. In everything that is happening around me. In everything that is happening in my province. In everything that is happening in my state. In everything that is happening in my nation. In everything that is happening in my job. In everything that is happening around me. Father, make me more than a conqueror. Make me more than a conqueror. Let me conquer, O God. Every plan of the wicked, let me conquer. Make us more than conquerors. Give us victory, O God. Give us victory, O God. From the noisome pestilence, from the COVID-19, Father, give us victory. Brethren, let's pray and say, God, give us victory. Let's say, God, give us victory. Let's say, God, give us victory. Exodus chapter 14, verse 14 says, I will fight for you and you will hold your peace. Let's pray and say, God, fight for us. Fight for our peace. Fight for our nation. Fight for our economy. Fight for the church. This is the time to fight for the church. Brethren, the church can never be silenced. We can never be silenced. Let's pray and say, God, fight for your church. Fight for your church. We can see the hand of God in what is happening. And all we are pleading is for divine intervention. Oh God of heaven, it's time for you to arise and fight for your church. It's time for you to arise and fight for your people. It's time for you to arise and fight for our land. Fight for our land. Let justice roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. Put an end to the plague, oh God. Let there be a demarcation between the Egyptians and the children of the Most High. Father, we ask for divine intervention. Make each and every one of us to be more than conquerors. In the name of Jesus, let's pray that the Lord will destroy every yoke of Satan. every yoke of Satan that Satan has decided to put on in the lives of men. Every yoke of Satan, yoke of sickness, yoke of ailment, yoke of diseases. Let's pray that in the mighty name of Jesus, that God will arise. God will arise and destroy every yoke of Satan in the name of Jesus. Thank you, the King of Glory. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Finally, I want us to pray. Even for our pastor, the man of God, that will be taking the message today, that we ask for a fresh unction. We ask for anointing. As many people that will minister in one way or the other, let's ask for divine unction. The Bible says, by the anointing, yokes shall be broken. We need fresh anointing to break every yoke of Satan today. Let's ask God and say, in the mighty name of Jesus, we ask for fresh unction. We ask for fresh anointing. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Holy Spirit will do what only you can do. We ask for fresh unction. That before we leave here today, we want to see Jesus lifted up. We want to see Jesus lifted up. We want to see revival in our lives. Thank you, the Ancient of Days. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. And so, Father, we thank you for today. We give you all the glory. We give you all the adoration. We bless you because the Bible says in all things we should give thanks. We're so grateful unto you. We are not moved by what is happening around us because we know it is the purpose of God to fulfill our own destiny. And so we ask, oh God, that you will take preeminence of today's service. We ask, oh God, that your name alone will be glorified. We ask, oh God, that in the name of Jesus, you will break every yoke of the enemy. We ask that today you will make us more than conquerors. We plead the blood of Jesus upon every member of chapel. We plead the blood of Jesus upon every member of RCCG. And we ask, oh God, that today you will visit us. You will give us our peace. And your name alone will be glorified. Take preeminence of today's service. And let only your name be lifted up. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I just want to announce that today, because of the government regulations, we're going to be going online. 100% of our services will be online. And for those of you that are joining us, please join us as we bring down the glory of God, hear the word of God, and just focus on what is most important at this time, to keep yourself safe and to continue to worship the King of Glory. Amen.
Alors, je voulais juste annoncer que suite au règlement ou à la décision du gouvernement, notre service va se faire en ligne à 100%.
Amen. Amen. So the choir, they're going to take the praise and worship now, and then the service is going to be starting just about now. God bless you.
Alors, la chorale va nous guider dans l'adoration à la louange et le service commence maintenant. Que Dieu vous bénisse.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's just exalt the name of the Lord. Raise your hand and say, Lord, I exalt you. I exalt you. With everything I am, everything I have.
Avec tout ce que j'ai, tout ce que je suis,
I exalt you.
Je t'exalte.
The only thing I know, that I have Jesus inside of me.
C'est que j'ai Jésus à l'intérieur de moi.
The Lord of Jesus is inside of me.
Le sang de Jésus est en moi.
And I can exalt him everywhere, anywhere, anytime.
Et donc je peux l'exalter partout, n'importe où je suis.
He deserves to be exalted.
Il mérite d'être exalté.
He deserves to be glorified.
Il mérite d'être glorifié.
I want you to raise your hand and say, Lord,
je vous remercie, Seigneur.
Inside of my heart. Deep inside of my heart,
au fond de mon cœur,
I exalt you.
Je t'exalte.
I exalt you.
Je t'exalte.
I exalt you.
Je t'exalte.
In Jesus' name, we exalt your name.
Au nom de Jésus, nous t'exaltons.
Amen.
Amen.
I exalt.
God with your hands and say, high exalted.
yes, you are not so great.
Let's go to God,
you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great. You're the miracle so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. Sing it, deserve the glory.
You deserve the glory
and the honor. There's no place for us.
You are God. clap your hands and rejoice in the Lord. He's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. I want you to clap your hands and praise the Lord.
I'm coming, Seigneur.
Hallelujah.
Blessing the name of Jesus. Amen. We are praising the Lord. Amen.
In the spirit of the Lord, come upon my life. I will praise and give you praise.
Oh,
over. Jesus, to you belong all power. Jesus, whenever I call your name, you make a way. Your name is a strong tower. Jesus, your name is a strong tower.
Jesus, do you belong all
of the tower.
Can the choir stay? We are going to take out this song, When Peace Like a River Attended My Way. When peace like a river attended my way. When sorrow. Amen. When peace like a river attended my way.
Next week for the technical.
Brethren, let us worship our God.
Bien-aimé, adorons le Seigneur.
Let us worship our God.
Adorons notre Seigneur.
Let us exalt our God.
Exaltons notre Seigneur.
Let us magnify our God.
Brethren,
let us praise our God.
Louons notre Seigneur.
He deserves all the glory.
Il mérite toute la gloire.
He deserves all adoration.
Il mérite toute adoration.
He deserves all exaltation.
Il mérite toute exaltation.
Let us worship him this morning.
Adorons-le.
Because his name is a strong tower.
Parce que son nom est
fort. The Bible says, when we call him,
lorsque nous le
voulons,
answer
us. Let us worship our God. Let us worship. Let us worship. Let us appreciate our God. Let us exalt our God this morning. Because our God is so great. Because our God is so powerful. Because our God is so wonderful. Because our God is so powerful. Because our God is so great. Let us exalt his name this morning. Let us exalt his name this morning. Let us worship him this morning. With all our heart, let us worship him. With all our heart, let us worship him. Let us bow before our God.
Prosternons-nous devant le Seigneur ce matin et adorons-nous. Exaltons son nom. Notre Seigneur est excellent. Notre Seigneur est puissant. Notre Seigneur est si
grand.
Personne ne peut se comparer à notre Dieu. Notre Dieu est si
puissant.
Let us worship
our God this morning. Let us appreciate our God this morning. Father, we worship you this morning. We worship you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's read 2 Chronicles 20, verse 7.
Lisons 2 Chroniques 20, verset 7.
What did the Bible say? Are you not our God who drove up? No, excuse me. 2 Chronicles 20, verse
14.
Deux Chroniques 7, verset
14. Praise the Lord. So we are going to pray. This verse is, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. But then we are going to pray God this morning.
Bien, nous allons prier le Seigneur ce matin.
Especially for our country, Canada.
Surtout pour notre pays, Canada.
We are going to cry before God for our country.
Nous allons invoquer le Seigneur pour notre pays.
The Bible says, if my people who are called by my name,
elle dit, si mon peuple
will humble themselves,
invoque mon nom,
and pray and seek my face,
cherche et prie,
and pray and seek my face,
cherche et prie,
if they turn from their wicked ways,
s'ils détournent de leurs mauvaises voies,
I will hear them from heaven.
Je vais les entendre aux cieux.
I will forgive their sins.
Je vais les pardonner.
And I will heal their land.
Et je vais guérir leur terre.
To cry before God.
Ça, c'est le temps d'invoquer le Seigneur.
To cry before God.
Ça, c'est le temps d'invoquer le Seigneur. Ça, c'est le temps d'invoquer le Seigneur, bien-aimé.
To ask God to forgive our sins.
Ça, c'est le temps pour demander au Seigneur de pardonner nos péchés. C'est le temps de le demander de guérir
notre pays.
C'est le temps de demander au Seigneur de guérir notre pays. C'est le temps de le demander de guérir notre terre. Crions devant le Seigneur ce matin. Le Seigneur nous entend.
Our God is here right now, brethren. Why don't we worship God this morning with all our hearts? Why don't we pray before Him this morning and right now? Why don't we ask Him to forgive us this morning? If we call on Him, if we
humble
ourselves, if we seek His face,
the Bible says
He will heal us, brethren.
If
we come and heal our land this morning,
Father,
we come before You this morning, Lord. Lord, we exalt You, Father. Lord, we ask You for forgiveness. Father, forgive our sins. But then, as we usually do, we usually pray for 5 countries every Sunday.
Comme nous le faisons chaque dimanche, nous prions pour quelques
pays.
So
we are going to pray for these 5 countries today.
Alors nous allons prier pour ces 5 pays.
So we are going to pray for El Salvador.
Nous allons prier pour le El Salvador.
We are going to pray for Greece.
Pour le Grèce.
We are going to pray for Finland.
Pour la Finlande.
We are going to pray for Iran.
Pour l'Irlande.
And we are going to pray for Albania.
Et pour l'Albanie.
But then we know what's going on all around the world right now.
Bien-aimés, nous savons qu'est-ce qui se passe dans le monde.
So only our God can give peace.
Et seulement notre Seigneur peut donner la paix.
The peace that God gave us.
Il avait dit que la paix que le Seigneur nous donne.
That peace, but then.
Le monde ne peut nous donner.
The world can make us, you know, fear, scare.
Le monde peut nous effrayer.
But our God can give us peace.
Mais le Seigneur
our
peut
God
nous donner la paix.
Peace.
Le Seigneur peut
but
nous donner la paix.
We are going to pray and lead this country before God to that today.
Bien aimé, nous allons prier.
We are going to ask for grace for them.
Et nous allons remercier Dieu.
We are going to ask
Seigneur
for favor
de demander
for them.
Pour la grâce et
we are
la
going
faveur.
To ask God to touch them.
Nous allons demander que le Seigneur
touche the leaders.
Touche les dirigeants.
The same thing, you know, the Bible says, you know, the sons of Issachar.
La même façon que David veut dire que les
chants d'Issachar, you know, about what to do when Israel is in trouble.
Les fils d'Issachar savaient quoi faire quand
so
Israël était en trouble.
So we are going to leave this country before God today.
Alors nous allons élever ces pays
dans la main du Seigneur. Of the this morning,
et que tous les dirigeants
de cette
pays.
Ask God to touch them.
Que le Seigneur
we are going to ask
toucher.
God to grant them wisdom.
Que le Seigneur les
we are going to ask
sagesse.
God to grant them understanding this morning. Especially in the situation that we are now.
Surtout dans la
so that the leader will not
trouvons.
Take decisions against you know, their people.
Et si les
but
they
will take decisions you know, for their people.
Leur
but we are going to lead them before God. Only God can help them with them. Only God can touch them. Only God can lead them. Only God can guide them. Only God can protect them. We are going to pray before God this morning. We are going to pray our God this morning. Our God will touch them. Our God will touch them. Our God will heal their land. Our God will heal their voice. Our God will heal their pride. Our God will touch them this morning. Father, we call for you, Lord. We ask for wisdom, O Lord. For wisdom, we ask, O Lord. We ask for wisdom, Father. We ask for understanding this morning. Come to this country, O Lord. Let them experience the peace that you give. Let them experience the salvation that you give. Let them experience the grace.
that you give, Father. Let me explain to you, Lord. Lord, I pray this morning that you will hear our cry. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Brethren,
we are going to pray for the blood of Jesus Christ. We are going to pray the blood of Jesus Christ to touch everyone. Us in this assembly this morning.
Nous allons demander que le sang de Jésus touche chaque personne.
The blood of Jesus to cover us.
Nous allons demander que le sang de Jésus couvre.
We ask the blood of Jesus to cover our family.
Nous allons demander que le sang de Jésus couvre notre famille.
Everyone that cannot be here this morning.
Que le Seigneur couvre toute
personne. We pray for the blood of Jesus to touch us, to cover us wherever we are.
Que le sang de Jésus nous cache.
But this thing that they call COVID-19 is only COVID-19.
On l'appelle ce virus le COVID-19.
But the blood of Jesus Christ can cover hundreds, thousands, millions, billions. That's why we are going to pray on the blood of Jesus Christ this morning.
To cover us with it.
To cover us against every fear.
Qui nous couvre de toute peur, de toute panique.
We are going to ask for the blood of Jesus Christ.
Nous allons demander le sang de Jésus de nous garder,
to keep us safe,
de nous sécuriser, de sécuriser la famille, de sécuriser notre pays, de sécuriser notre pays.
In Jesus' mighty name, let us plead on the blood of Jesus Christ this morning.
Bien aimé, invoquons le sang de
Jésus to cover this country.
Que le sang de Jésus couvre
the blood of Jesus Christ to cover this city of Gatineau.
Que le sang de Jésus couvre
the blood of Jesus to cover our leaders in this country. And ask for the blood of Jesus to have to touch them this morning. And ask for the blood of Jesus Christ to touch us, to give them direction.
Et qu'il les donne la direction.
To lead them to take the right decision. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Father, we come before you, Lord. We thank you this morning. Father, we thank you for your blood.
Merci pour ton sang.
That you shed for us 2,000 years ago. Father, we thank you for this blood.
Merci Seigneur pour ce sang.
It's alive, Father.
Il est
Father, we thank you for your precious blood.
Merci pour ton sang
that redeemed us. That give us hope.
Donne l'espoir.
In every hopeless situation.
Dans les situations
your blood always gives us hope.
Ton sang nous donne de l'espoir.
We worship for that precious blood. May your name be glorified. May your name be exalted.
Father,
we worship your name. We worship you, Lord. We give you all the glory. Please, Father, cover your church.
Cover your church under your power.
Cover your church under your grace.
Cover your church under
your promises, Lord.
Father, we worship you this morning.
Father, we worship you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Gloire au Seigneur.
We are going to take a hymn. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Quel ami fidèle et tendre.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
Quel ami fidèle et tendre.
Brother, I want you to know that if your trust is in the system has failed.
Bien aimé, si votre confiance est dans le système, le
but
système
we have a friend that has not failed.
Mais nous avons un ami qui n'échouera jamais.
His name is Jesus.
Et son nom est Jesus.
So we're going to take the first three stanzas in English and we're going to take the first three stanzas in French.
Nous allons chanter trois couplets en anglais et trois couplets en français.
Let's rest on the feet.
What a friend we have.
Almighty and everlasting God, we want to thank you.
Dieu puissant éternel, nous voulons te remercier.
Because you are the Almighty.
Parce que tu es le tout puissant.
You have been faithful. You have been awesome in our life.
Tu as été fidèle et merveilleux dans
notre vie. This morning, as we want to go into your word.
Père, ce matin, comme nous voulons écouter ta parole.
Father, we ask oh God that you will speak to us.
Père, nous te demandons de nous parler.
Especially our brethren that are watching online.
Particulièrement pour nos frères qui nous suivent.
Let the power that is present in this altar flow to them also.
Que la puissance qui est dans cet autel.
Let your word. Let your word have an impact, oh God.
Que ta parole ait un impact, oh Dieu.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Au nom puissant de Jésus.
Let me hear better, amen.
Amen.
May be seated.
Let us work.
I want to bless the name of the Lord for the opportunity to have this kind of service today.
Je bénis le nom de l'Éternel pour ce privilège d'avoir ce type de service.
In those days when we were in the university,
à cette époque on était encore à l'université,
we heard of the underground church.
Nous avons entendu parler des églises qui étaient sous sol.
Some brethren that escaped from China and Russia, they were telling us how they were doing church underground in the basement. And
des frères de la Chine, de la Russie nous informaient comment ils se réunissaient en cachette.
But we give glory to God that He's getting to that stage now in the world.
Et nous rendons gloire à Dieu parce que nous avons ce niveau-là dans le monde aujourd'hui.
Because after this, I'm not sure church will become what it used to be before that.
Après ça, je ne sais pas si l'Église va reprendre son état qu'il avait.
But we know that the church survived communism.
Mais nous savons que l'Église a survécu le communisme.
Socialism and communism Russia.
L'Église a survécu le socialisme et le communisme.
And I know that the church will survive this time also.
Et je sais que l'Église va survivre en cette époque encore.
I want to thank the Lord for the technology that is available for us today.
Nous remercions l'Éternel pour la technologie qui est disponible pour nous aujourd'hui.
I want to thank God that that technology enables us to broadcast from any nook and crannies. We can have the church and broadcast to the whole world.
Parce que cette technologie nous permet de diffuser tous les services, toutes les nouvelles que nous pouvons avoir de l'Église partout dans le monde.
But brethren, most importantly, I want us to focus on what our heart should be at times like this.
Mais la chose la plus importante est que nous devons nous concentrer sur ce que notre cœur devrait être en ce moment.
Tell you that this is a trying time in the life of families and individuals.
Je veux vous assurer bien aimé que ça c'est un moment de preuve de c'est dans la vie des
individuels. If you are there, if your hope and your faith is always in the physical things in the system that the government have set up, then you will agree with me that hope has been dashed.
Et si vous êtes là et que votre espoir est dans les choses matérielles, dans le système du gouvernement, vous serez d'accord avec moi que cet espoir-là a failli.
Because every day I'm beginning to realize that the only way we can survive, both as a family, as individual, or as a nation, is to depend on the Almighty.
Parce que chaque jour, je comprends que la seule façon de survivre sur le plan individuel, familial ou national, c'est de dépendre de Dieu Tout-Puissant.
I want you to know that this situation is not new in the world.
Vous devez savoir que cette situation n'est pas nouvelle dans le
Even
monde.
Even throughout the Bible, this situation has persisted, where pandemics has killed people.
Même partout, à l'époque de la Bible, il était cette situation a persisté où il y a eu des pandémies qui ont tué des gens.
Brethren, this is a way that God wants to use to draw the attention of the world.
Bien aimé, ça c'est une façon que Dieu veut se servir pour attirer l'attention.
So those that think that they are powerful.
Alors c'est ceux qui pensent être trop puissants.
I'm very happy that now they know that their power has limits.
Et je suis heureux parce que maintenant ils se rendent compte que leur puissance, leur pouvoir a des limites.
The government that think that they are almighty because they have money, they have power, they can do anything. Now they know that there is limitation.
Le gouvernement qui pensaient qu'ils sont tout puissants parce qu'ils ont de l'argent, ils ont de pouvoir, ils peuvent tout faire. Maintenant là, ils ont compris qu'ils sont limités.
All the people that think that they have power to control the life of men and women around them, now they know that there is limitation.
Là, toutes les personnes qui pensaient qu'il y avoir de l'argent, de pouvoir, de contrôler les hommes et les femmes autour d'eux, maintenant ils ont compris qu'ils ont des limites.
My prayer is that God will have mercy.
Ma prière est que Dieu ait pitié.
And this time will be shortened.
Et ce moment-ci sera raccourci.
Because if it's not shorting,
parce que si ce moment n'est pas raccourci,
the consequences could be very dire.
Les conséquences peuvent être vraiment
just
sévères.
Just in the news yesterday, 500,000 people went on employment insurance.
Selon les nouvelles hier, plus de 5,000 personnes sont allées déclarer dans le chômage.
This time last year, it was just 27,000.
Mais à cette époque, l'année passée, c'était environ 27,000
But just in the month of February, March,
mais juste pour le mois de février, de mars,
500,000 people.
500,000 personnes.
And so you see that if this does not, if this situation is not cut short, then it's going to be a dire problem both for the nations and for the world.
Donc vous voyez que cette situation ici n'est pas vraiment abrégée, n'est pas raccourcie, ça sera des conséquences très sévères pour la nation et pour les
États-Unis. It is also a clear indicator in the news that in the US, the sales of guns has increased so dramatically.
Et c'est aussi un indice que aux États-Unis, la vente des armes a augmenté vraiment de façon vraiment très
so why are people buying guns?
Mais pourquoi les gens achètent?
How does gun help us to fight coronavirus?
Comment les armes peuvent nous aider à combattre le coronavirus?
But you see, this brings us back to the Bible.
Ceci nous ramène dans la Bible.
The Bible says that the heart of man is desperately wicked. Who can know it?
La Bible nous dit que le cœur de l'homme est désespérément méchant.
Tell me, what is the importance of buying guns in thousands? People are queuing up to buy guns instead of food in the US just to equip themselves so that they can do what is in their heart as men.
Donc, la raison pour laquelle les gens vont acheter des armes plutôt que de la nourriture, ils se sont équipés des armes pour faire le mal qui est dans leur cœur.
In the midst of all these chaos,
dans toutes ces choses ici,
what should be our attitude?
Que devrait être notre attitude?
Amen.
Amen.
You know, there's a psalm that is very common that most of us have read several times.
Il y a un chant que beaucoup d'entre nous avons lu, qui est vraiment commun.
Psalm 91 from verse 1 to the end, if you have time to read it.
Le psaume 91 du premier verset jusqu'à la fin, si vous avez le temps de lire.
But that is not the import of my message today.
Mais ça, ce n'est pas ça le point de mon message aujourd'hui.
The topic of my message today is about the mercy of God.
Le sujet de mon message d'aujourd'hui, c'est la miséricorde de Dieu.
Because I want to tell you that in as much as the nations need the mercy of God, we as individuals, we need the mercy of God.
Je vais vous dire, comme les nations ont besoin de la miséricorde de Dieu, nous aussi sur le plan individuel, nous avons besoin de la miséricorde.
Yesterday, at the Good Morning Holy Spirit, we prayed for the mercy concerning our families and individuals.
Hier, pendant notre service de Bonjour Saint-Esprit, nous avons imploré la miséricorde de Dieu pour nos familles et nous-mêmes.
We looked at the things that can trigger mercy.
Nous avons examiné les choses qui peuvent la
we said prayer and fasting can trigger mercy.
Nous avons vu que la prière et le jeûne peuvent déclencher la miséricorde.
We said if you are a man or a woman that does not understand the importance of prayer, this is the time to go back to the place of prayer.
Nous avons vu que si vous êtes un homme ou une femme qui ne comprenez pas l'importance de la prière, ça c'est le moment de retourner à la prière.
I remember last year, you know, in November, our daddy the Lord said we should fast.
Je me rappelle l'année passée, au mois de novembre, notre Père dans le Seigneur a dit que nous devions jeûner pendant 30 jours.
And in February, in January, they said we should fast for 50 days.
Et au mois de janvier, on devait jeûner pendant 50 jours.
Some people just laughed at it and said, why are we fasting? What is going on? Because everything was doing good, everything was fine.
Certaines personnes ont ri et dit pourquoi nous devons jeûner parce que tout va bien.
Now, the problem has started.
Et là, le problème a commencé.
Because you know, in that prophecy in January, I remember, Daniel the Lord said that the earth will be like a child that is under convulsion, about to die.
Dans cette prophétie, notre Père dans le Seigneur a dit que la terre sera comme un enfant qui est frappé des convulsions, qui est sur le point de mourir.
That the people of God ought to pray.
Que le peuple de Dieu doit prier.
But you know that in most churches today, that is the last thing that is happening. Nobody wants to pray.
Vous savez, dans beaucoup d'églises aujourd'hui, la prière est la dernière chose qui se passe. Beaucoup de gens ne veulent pas prier.
People just want to feel cool. Everything is cool. Everything is fun.
À l'aise, tout va bien.
Brethren, the fun is over.
Yeah, bien aimé, l'amusement est passé.
You know, I was listening to a message this morning, and that is the Lord said, if you have not fasted before, this is time for you to start fasting.
J'ai suivi le message ce matin, notre Père dans le Seigneur. Si vous n'avez jamais jeûné auparavant, ça c'est le moment de jeûner.
But those of us that have fasted before,
mais ceux qui ont jeûné avant,
this is the time to be at peace.
Ça c'est le moment de se reposer. De
because partir. The Almighty God of heaven has gone ahead of us.
Parce que le Dieu tout-puissant du ciel nous a précédé.
And that was why when I was coming, I told all of us last Sunday that the Lord opened my eyes and told me that all the people that He has given unto us are going to be saved during this period.
Et le dimanche passé, j'ai dit le Seigneur a ouvert mes yeux et m'a dit que tout le peuple qui nous a donné, tous ces gens-là seront saints et saufs pendant cette période.
It's not only that they are going to be saved.
Non seulement qu'ils seront épargnés.
They will never lack anything good.
Ils ne manqueront rien de bien.
None of them will lose their job. None of them will be destitute.
Personne ne perdra son emploi. Personne ne sera destitué.
Because we have fasted several months, several days before now.
Parce que nous avons jeûné plusieurs mois, plusieurs jours avant.
Asking God for His mercy.
Et on demandait la miséricorde de Dieu.
I know it's not everybody that will do the fasting.
Je sais pas, c'est pas tout le monde qui.
But as long as a church, we have gathered, we pray every day.
Mais en tant qu'église, nous sommes réunis, nous avons prié chaque jour.
So I want to declare to you that you have no reason to be afraid.
Alors je vais déclarer ce matin que vous n'avez aucune raison d'avoir peur.
The God of heaven that we call every day is there for us now.
Le Dieu du ciel que nous invoquons chaque jour, il est là pour nous.
Yeah, the Bible says 1,000 shall fall by our right, 10,000 by our left.
La Bible nous dit que 1,000 tombera à notre côté, 10,000 à notre droite.
But he promised they will not come near our dwelling place.
La promesse est que cela ne nous atteindra pas.
Because we have received mercy.
Parce que nous avons obtenu miséricorde.
Let somebody shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at the scripture. Let's look at Matthew chapter 9, verse 27 to 34.
Matthieu 9, verset 34.
We need to recognize the difference between mercy and grace.
Nous devons reconnaître la différence entre la miséricorde et la grâce.
Between mercy and grace.
La miséricorde et la grâce.
By grace we are saved.
Nous sommes sauvés par la grâce.
Grace is unmerited favor.
La grâce, c'est la faveur imméritée.
But mercy replaces judgment.
Mais la miséricorde remplace le jugement.
So as the judgment of the Lord is walking around the whole heart.
Alors pendant que le jugement de Dieu passe partout sur la terre,
mercy will keep his own people.
Mais la miséricorde gardera son peuple.
So there is a lot of difference as oh, I am saved by grace. Congratulations.
Il y a beaucoup de différences. Vous direz que je suis sauvé par la grâce. Félicitations.
But have you received mercy?
Mais avez-vous obtenu miséricorde?
Mercy is not getting the judgment that you deserve.
La miséricorde, ce n'est pas recevoir le jugement que vous méritiez.
Praise the Lord.
Gloire au Seigneur.
So if you look at that story in Matthew chapter 9 from verse 27 to 34.
Matthieu 9, verset 34.
When Jesus departed from there, two blind men followed him, crying out and saying, Son of David, have mercy on us. And when he had come into the house, the blind men came to him. And Jesus said to them, Do you believe that I am able to do this? And they said to him, Yes, Lord. Verse 29. Then he touched their eyes, saying, According to your faith, let it be to you. Verse 30. And their eyes were opened. And Jesus standing warned them, saying, See that no one knows it. Verse 31. But when they had departed, they spread the news about him in all that country. Verse 32. As they went out, behold, they brought to him a man mute and demon possessed. Verse 33. And when the demon was cast out, the mute spoke, and the multitude marveled, saying, It was never seen like this in Israel. And last verse. But the Pharisees said, He cast out demons by the ruler of the demons. Praise the Lord.
Glory to God.
If you look at that story that we have read,
si vous regardez l'histoire que nous venons de lire,
I'm going to point out some salient points for us to understand how you can receive mercy.
Je vais tirer certains points clés pour vous faire comprendre comment on peut obtenir miséricorde.
But I bet you are listening to me now and you are scared. You are scared.
Si vous me suivez maintenant et que vous avez peur.
But I bet you are listening to me now that you have not even heard about the Lord Jesus Christ.
Bien, vous me suivez maintenant mais vous n'avez jamais entendu parler du Seigneur Jésus-Christ.
And you begin to wonder how can I be saved in this situation?
Et vous commencez à vous demander comment puis-je être sauvé dans cette situation.
Brethren, this is not the first time that pandemic is going to cross around the world.
Ce n'est pas la première fois qu'il y a une pandémie dans le monde.
But this one is very noisy. Amen.
Cette pandémie ici a fait beaucoup de bruit.
This one makes a lot of noise.
Celle-ci fait beaucoup de bruit.
And it's good that it makes a lot of noise so that men may know that they have limitations.
Et c'est bien qu'il fait beaucoup de bruit pour que les gens sachent qu'ils sont limités.
You know, number one, before you can receive mercy, you must recognize that you need mercy.
Le premier point, avant d'obtenir la miséricorde, vous devez reconnaître que vous avez besoin de la miséricorde.
You must recognize that you and I, we need mercy.
Vous devez reconnaître que vous et moi, nous avons besoin de la miséricorde.
As long as you feel that you know all and you can do everything by yourself, by your own self, then you don't need God, you don't need mercy.
Alors, si vous pensez que vous avez tout ce qu'il faut et que vous pouvez tout faire par vous-même, en ce cas-là, vous n'avez pas besoin de la miséricorde.
Men, those two blind men, they knew that they were blind and they need their eyes to be opened.
Ces deux aveugles savaient qu'ils étaient aveugles et qu'ils avaient besoin de la vue.
So they sought Jesus.
Alors, ils ont cherché Jésus.
They said, "Can you go to verse 28?"
Regardons verset 28.
And they came to Jesus. And they said, "I'm sorry, verse 27, please."
Verset 27, s'il vous plaît.
Amen. Son of David, have mercy on us.
Fils de David, aie pitié de nous.
You see, they understand, they recognize that Jesus is the son of David.
Ils ont compris, ils ont reconnu que Jésus était le fils de David.
They recognized Jesus as the Prince of Peace, a King of Kings.
Ils ont reconnu Jésus en tant que prince de paix, le roi des rois.
And they appealed to him.
Et ils l'ont supplié.
So the first thing is that you must know that you also need mercy.
La première des choses, vous devez reconnaître que vous avez besoin de la miséricorde.
But if you feel that God cannot help you,
mais si vous pensez que Dieu ne peut pas vous aider,
continue to trust in science.
Alors continuez à avoir confiance dans la science.
Continue to trust in your bank account.
Ayez confiance dans votre compte bancaire.
There is no problem.
Il n'y a pas de problème.
But when the chips are down,
mais quand les choses
and money fails,
et que l'argent faillit,
when you run to him,
lorsque vous allez vers lui,
he may not be there to hear.
Peut-être il ne sera pas là pour.
And that's why this morning is very important.
C'est pourquoi ce matin c'est très important.
That one of the ingredients to receive mercy is to recognize the fact that you needed mercy.
Un des ingrédients pour recevoir la miséricorde, c'est de reconnaître que vous avez besoin de miséricorde.
Those two blind men,
juste comme ces deux aveugles,
they knew that they needed mercy.
Ils savaient qu'ils avaient besoin de miséricorde.
You know, I see a lot of people in, especially in North America, they live a life of recklessness.
Je vois beaucoup de gens, particulièrement en Amérique du Nord, qui vivent en désordre.
Oh, as long as I'm cool, I'm cool, no, everything is okay.
Aussi longtemps que je suis à l'aise, moi, tout va bien.
Oh, let us continue to party and do everything.
Continuons à célébrer, tout va bien.
But brethren, I want you to know that when the consequences of your action begins to haunt you,
bien-aimés, sachez que quand les conséquences de vos actions commencent à se manifester,
don't come and blame God.
Ne venez pas blâmer.
Oh, don't say God doesn't help me.
Non, Dieu ne me répond pas. Dieu ne répond pas aux prières.
Because when God was looking for you,
parce que quand Dieu vous cherchait,
you were living your own life.
Vous viviez votre propre vie.
Amen.
Amen.
Even people in the church,
même les gens dans l'église,
oh, they come to church on Sunday.
Ils viennent à l'église le dimanche,
but during the week they do other things.
Pendant la semaine, ils font toutes autres choses.
Oh, and they say nobody sees me.
Et oh, personne ne me voit.
Coronavirus can see everybody.
Coronavirus peut voir tout le monde.
God can see everybody.
Dieu peut voir tout le monde.
There is no hiding for the wicked.
Il n'y a pas de refuge pour les méchants.
Why do you think the whole world is shaking and they shut everything down?
Pourquoi pensez-vous que tout est fermé, le monde entier?
It's because they discovered that this enemy is invisible.
C'est parce qu'ils ont découvert que cet ennemi est
even
invisible.
If you are in your bedroom, he can fetch you out.
Même si vous êtes dans votre chambre à coucher, ça
whether you
coucher.
Are rich or you are poor, it doesn't matter.
Que vous soyez riche ou pauvre, peu importe.
Whether you have the best medical care or not, it doesn't matter.
Même si vous avez le meilleur système de santé, peu importe.
If your number is called,
mais si votre numéro est appelé,
you are going to leave.
Vous allez partir.
Amen.
Amen.
You better be ready.
Faites mieux d'être prêt.
Because this is just a rehearsal.
Parce que ça c'est juste une préparation.
Of greater challenges that is ahead of us.
Un grand défi nous attend.
Number two.
Deuxième point.
We must recognize God's authority and ability to give mercy.
Nous devons reconnaître l'autorité et la capacité de Dieu de faire miséricorde.
It's not enough, you know, there are a lot of people that are in church that are very religious.
Vous savez, il y a beaucoup de gens dans l'église qui sont religieux.
Oh, let them know that I go to church and I sing.
Qu'ils sachent que je vais à l'église et je chante dans la voix.
But do you really believe in the authority of God?
Est-ce que vous croyez vraiment dans l'autorité de
because
Dieu?
If you believe in the authority of God,
parce que si vous croyez dans l'autorité de Dieu,
your private life will correspond with your public life.
Votre vie privée va correspondre avec votre vie.
If you believe in the authority of the power of God,
si vous croyez dans l'autorité de la puissance de Dieu,
You will release confidence that your friends will know that there's something different with you.
Vous aurez cette confiance que même vos amis sauront qu'il y a quelque chose de différent.
If you believe in the authority of God,
si vous croyez dans l'autorité de Dieu,
it's not just believing with your mouth.
Ce n'est pas juste croire à votre bouche.
You will live it in your life.
Mais vous devez le vivre dans votre vie.
Your friends will look at you and say, oh, you are different.
Vos amis vont vous regarder et vont dire, toi tu es différent.
But immediately your friends cannot know the difference between you and the person that does not go to church.
Mais si vos amis ne peuvent pas reconnaître la différence entre vous et les gens qui ne vont pas à l'église.
You are not a believer.
Non, vous n'êtes pas croyant.
And you are not a candidate for mercy.
Et vous n'êtes pas un candidat pour la miséricorde.
Amen. Amen. People can convince you that you are a believer, you are a Christian. You can convince yourself.
Les gens peuvent vous convaincre que vous êtes croyant. Vous pouvez même vous convaincre vous-même.
You can convince yourself.
Vous pouvez même vous convaincre vous-même.
When the chips are down,
mais quand les choses ne vont pas bien,
your legs are going to start shaking.
Vos pieds vont commencer à trembler.
Because you don't understand the authority of Christ.
Vous ne comprenez pas l'autorité de Christ.
And so for us to receive mercy,
alors pour obtenir miséricorde,
we must agree that we needed mercy.
Nous devons être d'accord que nous avons besoin
number
de miséricorde.
Number two, we must recognize God's authority and ability to give mercy.
Deuxième point, nous devons reconnaître l'autorité, la capacité de Dieu de faire miséricorde.
Those blindness, son of David, have mercy on us.
Ces deux aveugles ont dit, fils de David, aie pitié.
They recognize the authority of God.
Ils ont reconnu l'autorité de Dieu
to give mercy,
de faire miséricorde.
Let's look at 2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 15.
2 Samuel 7:15.
2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 15.
2 Samuel 7:15.
So as you are in your house,
alors pendant que vous êtes dans votre
maison, as you are listening to me,
pendant que vous m'écoutez,
I want you to rethink your life.
J'aimerais que vous réconsidériez.
Are you ready to meet with the Lord?
Êtes-vous prêt à rencontrer le Seigneur?
Are you ready to meet with the Lord?
Êtes-vous prêt à rencontrer le
Seigneur?
Because
if you are not ready,
parce que si vous n'êtes pas prêt,
then you are not ready to recognize that authority.
Donc vous n'êtes pas prêt à reconnaître cette autorité.
But my message shall not depart from him, as I took it from Saul, whom I removed from before you. Amen.
Amen.
You know, in that place,
vous savez, dans ce passage,
Saul had mercy.
Et Saul avait obtenu une
miséricorde. Saul was a king of Israel. He had mercy.
Il était le roi d'Israël. Il avait trouvé
une miséricorde. But when he became king, he thought he became king by his connection and authority.
Mais quand il est devenu roi, il pensait qu'il est devenu roi par sa propre connexion et son autorité.
He started disobeying God.
Il a commencé à désobéir.
So you can see that you can have mercy today, it can be removed from you tomorrow.
Vous pouvez obtenir miséricorde de Dieu aujourd'hui et demain sera enlevé.
You see, Saul, that was king, you know, eating in the table of prophets, begin to now eat with witchcraft.
Saul, qui était prophète, qui était roi, qui mangeait avec les prophètes, a commencé maintenant à manger avec les sorciers.
He went to witchcraft to go and look for, okay, what is tomorrow? Because there was so much trouble in his life.
Il est allé même voir le magicien pour demander qu'est-ce qui arrivera demain.
He went to witchcraft to say, okay, what is going to happen in this
life? Il est allé voir ces gens, qu'est-ce qui va arriver?
The same Mr. Saul.
La même chose, le même monsieur.
And if you look at this, God is not saying, but my mercy shall not depart from him. That is David. As I took it from Saul, whom I removed from before you. When the mercy of God is removed from you,
lorsque la miséricorde de Dieu vous est retirée,
it is trouble.
C'est des problèmes, des troubles.
Saul had a bountiful amount of trouble.
Alors Saul a eu beaucoup de
Let's
problèmes.
Let's look at verse 28.
Regardons le verset 28.
So it's very easy that the authority of God is so powerful that he can give you mercy, he can remove it and give it to somebody else.
L'autorité de Dieu est tellement efficace qu'il peut vous donner la miséricorde aujourd'hui et la retirer et donner à quelqu'un d'autre.
In some families, there are some firstborn.
Dans certaines familles, il y a les aînés.
Nobody recognizes them as firstborn.
Et personne ne les reconnaît pas comme un parent.
But when they receive mercy,
mais quand ils obtiennent miséricorde,
just see things will begin to work together.
Vous verrez, juste les choses vont commencer à fonctionner ensemble.
And they take their position as firstborn.
Et ils vont reprendre leur position.
And if they don't use it properly,
mais s'ils ne l'utilisent pas correctement,
mercy will be taken away from them and give it to the last one.
La miséricorde sera retirée d'eux et donnée au cadet.
And you see the last one not doing very well.
Et vous verrez maintenant les cadets de la famille.
And the last one will just be saying, what am I doing wrong?
Et l'aîné va se demander, mais qu'est-ce qui ne va pas avec moi?
Because mercy has been taken away.
Tout simplement parce que la miséricorde lui a été retirée.
And now, O Lord God, you are God, and your words are true, and you have promised this goodness to your servant. That is David's prayer.
Ça c'est la prière de David.
That your word is good.
Que tes paroles sont vérité.
Your word is true.
Tes paroles sont vérité.
You have promised this goodness to your servant.
Promis cette bonté à ton
servant. So there's a promise of goodness and mercy to his servant.
Donc il y a la promesse de bonté et de miséricorde à ce serviteur.
But we must recognize that authority.
Mais nous devons reconnaître cette autorité.
Mercy is not something we can control.
La miséricorde, ce n'est pas quelque chose que nous pouvons contrôler.
Romans chapter 9, verse 18.
Romains 9, 18.
He said, he showeth mercy unto whom he willeth, and he taketh it away from whom he willeth.
Il fait miséricorde à qui il veut et peut le retirer.
So the only thing we can do is just to obey his word.
La seule chose à faire, c'est d'obéir à sa parole.
Keep ourselves pure.
Nous garder pur.
And ask God for mercy.
Et demander la miséricorde de Dieu.
Amen.
Amen.
Brethren, when you receive mercy.
Bien-aimés, quand vous obtenez miséricorde.
Number 3.
Troisième point.
When you receive mercy.
Lorsque vous obtenez miséricorde.
You can't help it, but tell others about it.
Vous ne pouvez pas le cacher, mais vous devez annoncer à d'autres personnes.
Even when they say, oh, don't give the testimony, or don't talk about it.
Même quand on dit non, ne faites pas de témoignage, n'en parlez pas.
You will be so excited about it that you will tell everybody.
Vous serez tellement excité, vous allez annoncer à tout le monde.
When a man receives mercy,
lorsqu'un homme obtient miséricorde,
you know that man cannot keep quiet.
Cette personne-là ne peut pas rester calme.
Brethren, a lot of people they say, oh, don't give testimony, and the devil will go and steal the testimony.
Beaucoup de gens disent non.
It's all lies.
Ne faites pas de témoignage, le diable va voler le témoignage.
When God shows you mercy,
lorsque Dieu vous fait miséricorde.
There is no way you can keep quiet.
Vous ne pouvez pas rester calme.
Look at those blind men.
Regardons ces deux aveugles.
Those blind men.
Ces deux aveugles.
When their eyes were open.
Quand leurs yeux étaient ouverts.
Jesus opened their eyes.
Jésus qui a ouvert leurs yeux.
He said, "Don't tell anybody."
N'annoncez à personne.
Keep it to yourself.
Gardez-les pour vous-même.
Did they keep quiet?
Ils sont restés calmes.
Somebody that is blind.
Quelqu'un qui est aveugle.
Now he can see.
Maintenant il peut voir.
Do you know a person that is blind?
Ouais, quelqu'un qui est aveugle.
Can eat poison without knowing it.
Peut manger même le poison sans le savoir.
Every time is night for him.
À chaque moment c'est la nuit pour lui.
He cannot recognize colors.
Il ne reconnaît pas les couleurs.
Suddenly his eyes is open.
Soudainement ses yeux sont ouverts.
He can see colors.
Il peut voir maintenant les couleurs.
He can see night and day.
Il peut voir le jour et la nuit.
He can look at flowers and trees.
Il peut regarder les fleurs et les arbres.
Don't you think that person will be excited?
Et ça ne voyez pas que cette personne sera excitée?
That is what it means to receive mercy.
C'est ça obtenir miséricorde bien aimé.
Let us stop living a life of mediocrity.
Arrêtons de vivre dans la médiocrité.
Where we just eat and we just eat. Sleep, eat, and die.
Manger, dormir, manger, mourir.
Let us look for something special.
Cherchons quelque chose de spécial.
That God can do in our life.
Que Dieu peut faire dans notre vie.
So that our mouth will not be quiet.
Pour que notre bouche ne soit pas.
One thing I love with the Church of Jesus Christ is this.
Une des choses que j'aime avec l'Église.
In the midst of challenges like this.
Dans les défis comme celui-ci.
The Church always triumphs.
L'Église triomphe toujours.
The God of Heaven always triumphs.
Le Dieu des cieux triomphe toujours.
Because this is the time that God will begin to do some. Wonderful miracles among his people.
C'est le moment que Dieu va faire des choses merveilleuses parmi
ses enfants. This is the time that God will begin to separate the churchgoer from the Christians.
C'est le moment que Dieu va commencer à préparer ceux qui vont à l'église.
This is the time that God will begin to separate those that are following the word and those that are following the word of God.
C'est le moment que Dieu va séparer ceux qui suivent le monde et ceux qui suivent la parole de Dieu.
Because he promised.
Parce qu'il a promis.
He will never leave us nor forsake us.
Il ne nous laissera jamais.
Let me hear a better amen.
Amen.
Let me hear a better amen.
Amen.
So when we receive mercy, we can't keep quiet.
Lorsque nous obtenons miséricorde, nous ne pouvons pas garder silence.
If you look at that Matthew chapter 9, verse 30 to 31.
Matthieu 9, 30 à 31.
Matthew chapter, He said their eyes were open, and Jesus standing warned them, saying, see that no one knows it. Look at verse 31. But when they had departed, they spread the news about him in where? In all that country.
Ils ont répandu sa
When we talk about evangelism.
Quand nous parlons de l'évangélisation.
Oh, we say people should go for evangelism.
Les gens doivent partir évangéliser.
Oh, they say, I'm shy, pastor, I'm shy.
Moi, je suis timide, pasteur,
I'm shy. It's because you have not received mercy.
Yes. C'est parce que vous n'avez pas obtenu miséricorde.
Oh, if you have received mercy.
Si vous avez obtenu miséricorde.
Like me that I'm in front of you.
Comme moi qui m'étais devant vous.
You are going to be in the front.
Vous serez devant.
I remember when we first started the church.
Je me rappelle quand on venait de commencer l'église.
I don't speak French.
Je ne parle pas français.
And I have to do evangelism.
Mais je devais évangéliser.
So I took my children that speak French.
Alors j'ai pris mes enfants qui parlent.
They followed me.
Ils me suivaient.
We were going from house to house in those days.
On allait de maison en maison à cette époque.
And somebody said he was going to call the police.
Quelqu'un dit il allait appeler la police.
To arrest us.
Pour nous arrêter.
Of course my children were afraid.
Bien sûr, mes enfants avaient peur.
I told them, I said, let him call police.
Je leur dis qu'il appelle.
So that when they lock us up,
quand on va nous arrêter, nous enfermer,
our name will be in the book of life, and we are going to jail for
this. Alors,
let somebody shout hallelujah.
Dans les livres de vie que nous étions emprisonnés pour l'évangélisation.
I have received mercy.
Bien aimé, j'ai obtenu miséricorde.
That's why, even if the country said they should shut down, there is no worship of God again.
Même si le pays doit fermer, plus d'adoration.
Me and my household, we will still worship the Lord.
Moi et ma maisonnée, nous continuerons à adorer
le Seigneur. Because I have received mercy, I cannot keep quiet.
J'ai obtenu miséricorde, je ne peux pas garder silence.
I cannot stop talking about it.
Je ne peux pas arrêter de parler.
Even if 90% of Canadians is infected with coronavirus.
Même si 90% des Canadiens sont affectés de ce virus, ils sont malades. Moi, je vais continuer à
prier.
Je vais crier vers le Dieu des cieux.
Because I have received mercy.
Parce que j'ai obtenu miséricorde.
I know what it is.
Je sais ce que c'est.
I don't know where I would have been today.
Je sais où je serais maintenant.
That is why today.
C'est pourquoi aujourd'hui.
You know, before they even said that we should not meet.
Avant, on ne devrait pas se
rassembler. Some people have even stayed in their house.
Certaines personnes restaient déjà dans leur maison.
Because they don't understand what mercy is.
C'est parce qu'ils ne comprennent pas la notion
But
de miséricorde.
When God has done something for you,
mais lorsque Dieu a fait quelque chose pour vous,
you will be ready to die for His cause.
Vous serez prêt à mourir pour sa cause.
That's why when I was traveling, I told somebody.
C'est pourquoi quand je voyageais, j'ai dit à
quelqu'un. The Bible says that for me to live is Christ.
Et la Bible dit que pour
And for me to die is gain.
La mort, c'est un gain pour moi.
Coronavirus is so small that it's not going to stop me from doing what I want to go.
Coronavirus est tellement petit. Ne pas m'empêcher
de faire everything.
On peut tout fermer.
We don't even know when it's going to be open.
On ne sait même pas quand est-ce qu'on va les réouvrir.
I want to tell you one.
Moi, je veux vous dire une chose.
The worship of God will still continue.
L'adoration de Dieu va continuer.
I said the worship of God will still continue.
L'adoration de Dieu va continuer.
But it takes a man that understands mercy.
Bien aimé, ça prend quelqu'un qui comprend la
miséricorde. What God can do.
Quelqu'un qui a vécu ce qui est
to make those conviction.
Pour avoir cette conviction.
And so that's why when you have received mercy.
C'est pourquoi quand vous avez obtenu miséricorde.
Nobody can hold you back.
Personne ne peut vous retenir.
Remember Daniel that I used.
yesterday.
Rappelez-vous Daniel que j'ai quand je parlais hier.
Yesterday Daniel.
J'ai dit Daniel.
They said nobody should pray to God.
Non, personne ne doit prier.
Some say, oh, this one is not attack to the Christian. I said, I agree with you.
Quelqu'un dit non, ça c'est pas une attaque aux chrétiens.
But the devil can change it to an attack to Christians.
J'ai dit mais le diable peut le changer.
Oh, yeah. It's a trial run.
Oui,
c'était un essai. And I said, we are waiting.
J'ai dit, nous attendons.
Because there are some of us that have received mercy.
Parce qu'il y a certains d'entre nous qui ont obtenu une miséricorde.
Daniel said, well, government, you have said your own. No.
Daniel a dit non, le gouvernement a pris sa décision.
I will still continue just as we are.
Mais moi, je veux continuer comme on sent.
Samuel, Daniel decided to pray 3 times a day.
Daniel a décidé de prier 3 fois par jour.
And he opened his window.
Et il a ouvert ses fenêtres.
He didn't do it in the corner.
Il l'a pas fait dans un coin.
He opened his window.
Il a ouvert ses fenêtres.
That's the man that I received mercy.
Ça c'est un homme qui a trouvé miséricorde.
Brethren, if you receive mercy,
bien-aimés, si vous obtenez miséricorde,
nobody can stop you.
Personne ne peut vous arrêter.
If you have received mercy,
si vous avez obtenu miséricorde,
nobody can quiet you.
Personne ne peut vous mettre.
If you see a man that is very gentle and does not want to be aggressive for the things of God,
si vous voyez quelqu'un qui est gentil, qui ne veut pas être
agressif. If you see a man that cannot pay his tithes, cannot give to the build to things of God,
vous voyez quelqu'un qui ne donne pas sa dîme, qui ne peut pas contribuer aux choses de Dieu,
that man has not received mercy.
Cet homme-là n'a pas encore obtenu miséricorde.
Brethren, when you receive mercy,
mais quand vous obtenez miséricorde,
there will be nothing too big for you to give.
Rien ne sera trop grand pour vous.
There will be nothing too big for you to give for the Lord.
Rien ne sera trop grand pour vous pour le Seigneur.
Including your life,
y compris votre vie.
When you have received mercy,
lorsque vous avez obtenu miséricorde.
And lastly, number 4,
finalement 4e point.
When mercy is granted,
lorsque la miséricorde est accordée,
it brings amazement.
Elle apporte vraiment des choses impressionnantes.
It brings what?
Amazement. Des choses vraiment impressionnantes.
You know, I tell people.
J'ai dit aux gens,
there are lots of people that are churchgoers.
Il y a beaucoup de gens qui fréquentent l'église.
They have not received mercy.
Ils n'ont pas obtenu miséricorde.
But you see, when you receive mercy,
mais quand vous obtenez miséricorde,
it comes with an amazement.
Et cela vous apporte des choses.
I remember the first time that God showed me mercy and I gave my life to Christ.
Je me rappelle quand Dieu m'a fait miséricorde pour la première fois et j'ai donné ma vie à Christ.
I didn't know the church has closed.
Je savais pas que l'église était fermée.
I didn't know that I took bus to the church.
Je savais pas que j'ai pris le bus vers l'église.
When they prayed for me,
mais quand on a prié pour
and
moi,
I gave my life to Christ,
et j'ai donné ma vie à Christ,
I ran from that church to my house.
J'ai couru de l'église jusqu'à chez moi.
I didn't wait for bus.
Je n'attendais pas le bus.
I was so amazed, so excited.
J'étais tellement excité.
You would think I won $1 million.
C'est comme si j'ai gagné $1 million.
When I got to the house,
et quand je suis arrivé à la maison,
was when I remember that I have run several kilometers.
C'est là que je me suis rendu compte que j'ai couru plusieurs kilomètres.
Because I have never known peace and joy.
Je n'avais jamais vécu la paix et la joie.
But God gave me peace and joy.
Dieu m'a donné la paix et la joie.
And my life, I never looked back since.
Et je n'ai jamais regardé en arrière depuis
ce moment. That amazement is going to be there when you receive mercy.
C'est impressionnant, ces choses impressionnantes.
There's going to be an amazement. That's why those people cannot keep quiet.
C'est pourquoi ces gens-là ne pouvaient pas garder silence.
When the children of Israel got to the Red Sea,
quand les enfants d'Israël sont arrivés à la mer Rouge,
and Pharaoh was at the back of them.
Et Pharaon le poursuivait.
And the rest was in front of
et
them.
La mer Rouge était devant eux.
Oh, the enemy was celebrating.
L'ennemi célébrait.
He said, we got it.
Ok, nous les avons eu.
Our strategy has worked.
Notre stratégie a fonctionné.
I'm sure the lieutenant of Pharaoh must have gone to have a cabinet meeting with Pharaoh.
Je suis sûr que même le gouvernement de Pharaon s'est réuni.
And they must have promoted that lieutenant colonel. And said, yeah, you are now a general.
Ils ont même promu, élevé même cette personne-là qui aujourd'hui maintenant tu es général.
You are here to pursue them.
Tu es là pour les poursuivre.
Now they can't cross the Red Sea.
La stratégie a fonctionné. Maintenant ils ne peuvent pas traverser
le Red Sea. Maintenant
ils n'ont pas les chars pour
courir. And we surrounded them.
Et nous les avons entourés.
And I'm sure they promoted him from lieutenant colonel to general.
Je suis sûr que cet homme-là a été promu de colonel vers
assistant Pharaoh.
Il est devenu assistant de Pharaon.
Because they thought they have won.
Parce qu'ils pensaient avoir gagné.
But God smiled from heaven.
Mais Dieu a souri.
Yes. Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Yeah.
And when you receive mercy, it's an amazement.
Quand vous obtenez miséricorde, vraiment, c'est vraiment impressionnant.
That miracle has not been done before.
Ce miracle n'a jamais été fait auparavant.
Nobody has divided the Red Sea before.
Personne n'avait jamais divisé la mer Rouge auparavant.
But God did it.
Mais Dieu l'a fait.
God did what?
Dieu l'a fait.
God did what? He did it.
Dieu l'a fait.
Today also.
Aujourd'hui aussi.
God can do a miracle that has never happened before.
Dieu peut faire un miracle qui n'a jamais été fait auparavant.
You can imagine if I'm a member of that congregation.
Imaginez-vous si j'étais membre de cette assemblée.
I went to meet Moses.
J'étais allé rencontrer Moïse.
I said, Moses, what are you doing?
Moïse, qu'est-ce que tu fais?
You want us to die in this wilderness?
Tu veux que nous puissions mourir dans ce désert?
It is natural.
C'est naturel.
For people to complain.
Pour les gens de se plaindre.
Because they do not see God.
Parce qu'ils n'ont pas vu
Dieu. You know what the Bible says?
C'est pourquoi la Bible
dit. The Bible says that Moses knew God.
La Bible dit que Moïse connaissait
Dieu. Knew the ways of God.
Il connaissait les voies de Dieu.
But the children of Israel knew only the acts of God.
Mais les enfants d'Israël savaient seulement les œuvres, les actes.
For you to receive mercy.
Mais pour obtenir miséricorde.
You must know the ways of God.
Vous devez savoir les voies de Dieu.
You must know the ways of God.
Vous devez savoir les voies de Dieu.
You must not panic when there is panic.
Vous ne devez pas paniquer au moment de paniquer.
You must continue to serve the Almighty.
Vous devez continuer à servir le Tout-Puissant.
Can you imagine if Moses had panicked?
Imaginez-vous si Monique et Moïse étaient dans la panique.
If Moses had panicked,
si Moïse était, avait aussi paniqué,
he won't hear God again.
Il n'allait pas écouter Dieu.
The first thing we see is he said, put on your safety jacket. We are diving into the ocean.
La première chose à dire,
people would have
portez vos gilets de sauvetage, nous allons nager dans la mer.
Because you would have said, okay, scientist, how many kilometers is this?
Les scientifiques, okay. C'est combien de kilomètres?
How many of you can swim?
Combien de vous peuvent nager?
Okay, those of you that cannot swim. Only people that can swim.
Vous ne pouvez pas nager. Tenez, nous allons nager, nous allons nager.
It will be a different story today.
Ça serait une histoire différente aujourd'hui.
So someone I said, if you want to be a Christian,
j'ai dit à quelqu'un, si tu veux être chrétien aujourd'hui,
you want to lead people,
vous voulez diriger des gens,
you better not panic.
Vous ferez mieux de ne pas paniquer.
If you panic,
si vous paniquez,
you just follow their ways.
Vous allez suivre leur voie.
And everybody perish.
Et tout le monde sera péri.
But Moses said,
et Moïse a dit,
somebody called me.
Quelqu'un m'a appelé.
Somebody sent me.
Quelqu'un m'a envoyé.
Let us listen to him.
Alors écoutons-le.
And when God was going to respond,
et quand Dieu devait réagir,
he said, Moses, what is in your hand?
Moïse, qu'est-ce que tu as dans tes mains?
He said, ordinary rod.
Oh, j'ai juste un
he
bâton.
Said, stretch it to the sea.
Tends ton bâton vers la terre.
The Bible says there was an east wind.
La Bible dit il y avait un vent
and
de l'est.
The sea divided.
Et la mer a été.
And the children of Israel walk on dry
land. Et les enfants d'Israël ont marché sur la terre.
Amen. If it has held there.
Si cela était arrêté là.
If the amazement has ended there.
Si cela, ce miracle a été arrêté là. Ce serait bien.
But it didn't end there.
Mais ça ne s'est pas arrêté là-bas.
Stubborn pursuer.
Le poursuivait. Têtu, c'est que le poursuivait était têtu.
The children, the rest here has parted for them. They are passing.
La mer était divisée, ils traversent.
And I'm sure the man that was just promoted general.
Je suis sûr que l'homme qui a été promu général dans l'armée des pharaons.
He has his additional rank.
Il avait des.
He wants to prove himself.
Additionnel,
des Mr. Pharaoh, let's follow them.
Monsieur Pharaon,
if they can do it, we can do it.
S'ils peuvent le faire,
if their God can do it, our God can do it.
Si leur Dieu peut le faire,
we are even
nous sommes plus
we have more power.
Nous avons plus
we
de pouvoir. Nous avons des
we have money.
Nous avons
we
de
have everything.
Nous avons tout.
Scientists to do analysis to raise the war. To
nous avons même les scientifiques qui font des analyses.
Follow them.
Suivons-les.
But you know why Pharaoh followed them?
Vous savez pourquoi Pharaon les suivait?
Because the advice of that general has worked before.
Parce que le conseil de ce général là avait fonctionné avant.
He has history.
Il a vraiment l'histoire.
And his advice has worked before.
Et ses conseils ont fonctionné avant.
That's why they didn't bother to check it again.
C'est pourquoi ils ne se sont même pas demandé qu'il faut vérifier cela.
Oh, the wise man has spoken.
Oh non, le sage a parlé.
For those of you that look at the advice of the world.
Pour vous qui suivez les conseils du monde.
I said what worked last year will work this year.
Oh, ce qui a fonctionné l'année passée va fonctionner aujourd'hui.
He doesn't follow.
Non, ça ne fonctionne pas toujours comme ça.
They followed.
Ils l'ont suivi.
And as they followed,
et pendant qu'ils suivaient,
Moses went back to God.
Moïse est allé à Dieu.
Because God, the Bible says that God is a present help in time of trouble.
La Bible dit que Dieu est là dans le moment dans la détresse.
God does not expire.
Dieu n'expire jamais.
His strategy does not expire.
Sa stratégie n'expire jamais.
But the strategy of Pharaoh expires.
Mais la stratégie de Pharaon a expiré.
Amen. When I talk to people,
quand je parle aux gens,
trust God with your life.
Ayez confiance en Dieu.
Confiez your friends will fail you.
Vos amis vont vous
your money will fail.
Votre argent va.
Your career will fail.
Ta carrière va te décevoir.
The country will fail.
Et le pays va te décevoir.
Don't wait for it to fail you before you run to.
N'attendez pas d'abord la déception.
Make God your number one.
Que Dieu soit la priorité dans votre vie.
Make Him your number one.
Que soit la priorité, la première place dans votre
let
vie.
Let all that you have belongs to Him.
Que tout ce que vous avez appartient
à Dieu. The Bible says it declares the end from the beginning.
La Bible dit déclare la fin dès le début.
Before the strategy happens, He already knows what to direct you.
Avant même que la stratégie arrive, il sait déjà comment vous
diriger. Just focus on Him.
Juste concentrez-vous sur lui.
Brethren. When you do that,
bien aimé, quand vous faites cela,
you'll be amazed what he can do.
Vous serez impressionné de ce qu'il peut faire.
So Pharaoh followed.
Alors Pharaon a suivi.
And the Bible says that the wall of water.
La Bible dit que le mur d'eau
collapsed. And Pharaoh and every of his armies.
Et Pharaon avec toute son armée perished. Son péri.
Do you think the children of Israel will keep quiet?
Vous savez que les enfants, pensez-vous que les enfants d'Israël devraient garder silence?
Do you think they will keep quiet?
Vous savez qu'ils allaient garder silence?
They cannot keep quiet.
Non, ils ne peuvent pas garder silence.
And that's why you see Exodus chapter 15, verse 13.
C'est pourquoi dans Exode 15, 13,
the amazement.
C'était impressionnant.
Exodus chapter 15, verse 13.
Et 15, 13.
The amazement. They started singing unto the Lord.
Là, ils ont commencé à chanter.
They started rejoicing.
Ils ont commencé à se réjouir.
And look at what they said. You in your mercy have led forth the people whom you have redeemed. You have gathered them in your strength to your holy habitation. Amen.
Amen.
Did you see the importance of those words?
Vous savez,
he said, in the mercy, God has led the people whom you have redeemed. So,
par ta miséricorde, tu as conduit les peuples qui t'ont délivré.
Redeemed by God.
Si vous êtes racheté,
God will lead you.
Dieu va vous conduire.
He will lead you.
Il vous conduira.
Oh, I want to get married.
Oh, je veux me marier.
Oh, I must meet young people.
Oh, je dois rencontrer les
jeunes. Because if I don't go to parties and meet young people, I cannot see. The person, will marry, or the person that will marry me will not see me.
Si je ne vais pas dans des fêtes, la personne qui va m'épouser ne va pas me voir.
Demons will see you.
Les démons vous verront.
Amen.
Amen.
Demons will see you.
Les démons vous verront.
You know, I used to have a sister.
J'avais une sœur.
That came to me several years ago.
Qui est venue vers moi il y a plusieurs années.
She was a prayer band, very prayerful sister.
Elle était membre du groupe de prière. Elle priait beaucoup.
And we thought she was a very serious sister.
Et on pensait qu'elle était vraiment sérieuse.
Suddenly, when she was getting old and she wanted to, the brothers are not coming.
Mais là, quand elle grandissait en âge et qu'il n'y avait pas de frères qui se présentaient,
she began to be very agitated.
Elle devient maintenant agitée.
Be patient.
Sois patiente.
So one day she went to a birthday party.
Un jour, elle est allée dans une fête.
In a friend's house.
Dans la maison d'un ami.
So somebody introduced one boy to him.
Et quelqu'un lui a présenté.
I know those boys now. They came.
Vous savez,
oh, you are the sugar in my tea, the cocoa in my cupboard. In fact, my cupboard is not complete without your cockroach and you know all this kind of sweet talk.
Tu es le sucre dans mon thé. Mon armoire n'est pas complète avec sans les cancrelats.
They got married.
Ils se sont mariés.
Oh, there was rejoicing and dancing.
Il y avait la célébration dedans.
He's a Christian too. He's a Christian.
Elle a présenté le frère.
His name is Samuel.
Il est aussi chrétien. Son nom c'est Samuel. Il est chrétien.
Not this Samuel.
Non, pas Samuel. Non, c'est pas moi.
But brother, the marriage did not last more than 1 year.
Bien aimé, le mariage n'a pas duré plus d'une année.
Because demons have seen him.
Bah, les démons l'ont vu.
Of course, the demons have seen him.
Oui, bien sûr, les démons l'ont
so
vu.
So demons created. So the devil is their father-in-law.
Non, les diables, c'est son beau-père.
It didn't last 1 year.
Le mariage n'a pas duré.
Because many they got married.
C'est toi qui se sont mariés.
Stop the sister from coming to church.
Il a refusé, l'a empêché même la sœur d'aller à l'église.
Trouble started.
Les problèmes ont commencé.
The rest is story.
Le reste est l'histoire.
Sister is already having a child.
La sœur avait déjà un enfant.
By the time she was talking to me,
au moment qu'elle me parlait,
she was weeping like a baby.
Elle pleurait comme un bébé.
What can we do?
Que pouvons-nous faire?
Nothing.
Et rien.
Did God answer prayer?
Est-ce que Dieu a
répondu? Oh, God answers prayer.
Oui, Dieu répond aux prières.
But he never waited for his mercy.
Mais elle n'a jamais attendu pour obtenir sa miséricorde.
Oh, my friend did it and got away with it.
Oh, mon ami l'a fait. C'est bien.
You will not get away with it.
Et vous n'allez pas vous en sortir.
He said, you have guided them in your strength. Which means God has a strength that he uses in guiding.
Il les a conduits par ta puissance. C'est-à-dire que Dieu a la puissance par laquelle il dirige son peuple.
God, you know, God has a strength.
Dieu a une force.
When the children of Israel got to the Red Sea,
quand les enfants d'Israël sont arrivés,
they thought that the end has come.
Ils pensaient que c'est la fin.
If not for the strength of God,
ni t'était la puissance de Dieu.
Sometimes God can lead you to a dead end.
Des fois, Dieu peut vous amener quelque part, il n'y a pas de
place. Oh, no way again, no place to go.
Il n'y a plus de place, pas de voie de sortie.
But he said, as he continued to trust in him,
mais pendant qu'il continuait à avoir confiance en lui,
in his strength,
dans sa force,
he will open the door.
Il va créer une voie.
That is the difference.
C'est ça la différence.
That is the difference.
C'est ça la différence.
You can see how the world is in confusion.
Vous voyez comment le monde est dans la confusion.
When
mercy comes,
mais quand la miséricorde arrive,
there's always an amazement.
Il y a toujours des choses impressionnantes.
God will touch somebody here today.
Dieu va toucher quelqu'un ici aujourd'hui.
And we wait for his mercy in Jesus.
Et vous allez attendre sa miséricorde au nom de Jésus.
Now,
maintenant,
number five.
Cinquième point.
There are people who does not like you to have mercy.
Il y a certaines personnes qui ne veulent pas que vous obteniez miséricorde.
There are some people who does not want you, any other person, to receive mercy.
Il y a certaines personnes qui n'aiment pas que d'autres personnes obtiennent
miséricorde. Look at verse 34.
Regardons maintenant le verset 34.
Verse 34 of Matthew chapter 9.
Verset 34 de Matthieu chapitre 9.
Young people, listen to me.
Jeunes gens,
look at verse 34 of Matthew chapter 9.
Regardons le verset 34 de Matthieu 9.
But the Pharisees said, he cast out demons by the ruler of the demons. So they will come to you and say, ah, why is your own too much?
Ces gens-là viendront vous dire, mais pourquoi? Pour toi, c'est trop.
Like a lady came to see me in my office on Friday, some of the observants on Friday and Saturday.
Well, il y a une chère qui est venue me voir dans mon bureau vendredi et samedi.
We can be sleeping together. Everybody does it.
Il lui disait que mais on peut coucher, on peut dormir ensemble. Yeah.
Grace will cover us.
La grâce va nous couvrir.
Grace will cover us.
La grâce de Dieu va nous couvrir.
Is it demon talking?
Donc voyez les démons parlent.
They will trivialize the things of God.
Ils vont banaliser les choses de Dieu.
I don't care who they are. They can be pastor, they can be bishop, they can be whatever position that they are.
Pasteur, l'archbishop, l'archevêque.
Immediately somebody is selling that to you that everybody does it.
Aussi longtemps que quelqu'un vous dit cela que tout le monde le fait,
run away from that person.
Oh, fuyez de cette personne.
That person is senior demon.
Cette personne-là, vraiment, c'est un démon.
It's not fake Christian, it's a senior demon.
C'est un démon titulaire.
It's the devil himself.
Ouais, c'est le diable lui-même.
Immediately somebody looked at you and said, oh, everybody does it.
Plutôt que quelqu'un te regarde, mais tout le monde le fait. Mais pourquoi toi tu es tout seul comme ça?
Oh, I just did it and he has a very good marriage.
La sœur a fait cela, elle a un bon mariage.
Because I have to test to be sure. I have to test.
Je dois tester pour être sûr.
Let somebody shout amen.
Amen.
They explain away.
Ils ont expliqué vraiment la voix.
The miracle of God.
Alors, le miracle de Dieu.
You see, there's a Pharisees. They are religious leaders.
Ce sont des leaders religieux.
They may be in the church too.
Ils peuvent être aussi membres de l'église.
Oh, come for prayer meeting.
Viens pour la prière. La
I've been praying all along. What has happened?
Mais nous avons prié depuis longtemps. Qu'est-ce qui est arrivé? Allons faire quelque chose d'autre.
After they will pray for all of us.
Après tout, ils vont prier pour nous tous.
They may be in the church.
Ils peuvent être aussi membres de l'église.
They may be your friends.
C'est peut-être vos amis.
They explain away the miracle of God.
Ils ont expliqué le miracle de Dieu.
They were even religious leaders.
Ils étaient des leaders religieux.
They trivialized the mercy of God.
Ils ont banalisé la miséricorde de Dieu.
Brother, let me tell you one secret.
Bien-aimé, laissez-moi vous dire un secret.
If I wake up in the morning,
si je me réveille le matin,
for the time that I'm able to wake up,
juste le fait que je me suis réveillé,
I attribute it to the Almighty God.
J'accorde ce fait là à la puissance de Dieu.
Because if God decides not to wake you up,
bah, si Dieu décide de ne pas vous réveiller,
nothing,
rien.
Even the job you think you are running to,
même le travail que vous pensez que vous
avez, you cannot even do it.
Vous ne pouvez même pas le
because
faire.
Because the owner of sleep did not wake you up.
Parce que le propriétaire du sommeil ne vous a pas réveillé.
That is how simple it is.
Voilà comment c'est simple.
Not to talk of when I wrote exam and they said I failed.
Et non pas parler de l'examen que j'avais fait et dire tu
as échoué. And I cried to God.
Et j'ai pleuré.
And they changed the result.
Ils ont changé le résultat.
I will never forget that one.
Je ne l'oublierai
pas. If you like, explain it with anything you want to explain it with.
Si vous voulez l'expliquer avec toutes sortes
d'explications. Every opportunity I have to talk, I will talk about it.
Chaque occasion que j'ai, je parlerai.
Or when I wanted to get married.
Quand je voulais me marier.
And Lord gave me a wonderful wife.
Et le Seigneur m'a donné une merveilleuse femme.
As someone said, I will not marry her.
Et comme certaines personnes diront,
je ne marierai pas. A particular amount of money.
Oh, tu dois apporter une certaine somme d'argent.
I did not have.
L'argent que je n'avais pas.
I cried unto him.
Je criais vers lui.
He made provision.
Il a pourvu.
I will never forget.
Je n'oublierai jamais cela.
So everything I am today,
chaque chose que j'ai aujourd'hui,
is because of him.
Ce que je suis aujourd'hui, c'est grâce à lui.
The other day, somebody said, was still looking at me as the way I was several years ago.
Yeah, un jour, quelqu'un me considérait comme j'étais là il y a plusieurs années avant.
And I smile.
Moi, je souris.
I smile.
Je souris.
So when we started talking,
et quand on commence à parler,
And I give him some money.
Je vais donner certaines
sommes. I'm sure he will go and tell those people that are around that this man is different.
Je suis sûr qu'il va aller annoncer aux gens là que non, cet homme ici est différent.
He has found mercy.
Il a obtenu miséricorde.
Brethren, there is mercy in being honest with him.
Bien aimé, il y a de la miséricorde en étant honnête avec lui.
But get to understand that there are some people that will not want you to have the mercy.
Mais vous devez comprendre qu'il y a certaines personnes qui ne veulent pas que vous ayez.
They will trivialize the things that God has done.
Ils vont banaliser les choses que tu as fait.
It's a miracle that we are here this morning.
C'est un miracle que nous sommes ici ce matin, bien aimé.
You know, during the Good Morning Holy Spirit, somebody said, "Oh, the police can come and stop us."
Pendant le bonjour Saint Esprit, quelqu'un a dit non, la police vient.
Even somebody said he will call police to us.
Même quelqu'un dehors a dit qu'il va appeler la police pour.
The only people that I pity are the people that are here. For me, I'm not afraid.
Les seules personnes dont je pitié, ce sont les gens qui sont ici parce que moi, je n'ai pas peur.
You take me.
Ils vont m'amener.
When I get there,
quand j'arrive là,
I'll preach the gospel to them.
Je vais prêcher et prêcher l'évangile.
For me, I'm not afraid.
Pour moi, je n'ai pas peur.
Amen. But it's just the people that are around.
C'est seulement les gens qui sont
autour. The lady, go and call the police.
Ils ont dit à la dame, va appeler la police.
We are here.
Mais nous sommes là.
But God helped us.
Dieu nous a aidés.
They didn't come.
Ils ne sont pas venus.
Today again, God has helped us.
Aujourd'hui, Dieu nous a aidés.
They didn't come.
Et ils ne sont pas venus.
Because we have received mercy.
Parce que nous avons obtenu miséricorde.
Brethren, I want you to know that when you receive mercy,
bien aimé, quand vous obtenez miséricorde,
you can break anything and nothing is going to happen.
Vous pouvez briser, transgresser n'importe quoi et rien ne peut arriver.
Let us learn to give all to Christ.
Apprenons à donner tout.
Let us learn to give all to Christ.
Apprenons à donner tout à Christ.
Let us learn to give our life to Christ.
Apprenons à donner nos vies à Christ.
So that we can receive mercy.
Pour que nous puissions obtenir miséricorde.
Let us pray.
Prions.
I want you to talk to God.
J'aimerais que vous parliez à Dieu.
The mercy of God.
La miséricorde de Dieu.
It's available for us.
Elle est disponible pour nous.
It's available for our family.
Elle est disponible pour nous.
In this trying time, for those of us that are so, that mercy is there.
Dans cette époque de test.
Have you been doubting his authority?
Est-ce que vous doutiez de son
autorité? Have you been doubting his provision?
Est-ce que vous doutiez de sa provision?
Why don't you ask him for mercy?
Pourquoi pas demander miséricorde?
That God should forgive you.
Que Dieu vous pardonne.
That God should forgive you.
Que Dieu vous pardonne.
You have doubted his provision.
Vous avez douté de sa provision.
Oh, do you think he cannot lead you?
Vous pensez qu'il ne peut pas vous diriger?
Why don't you say, ask God for forgive?
Pourquoi pas demander le pardon?
Ask God to forgive you.
Demandez à Dieu de vous pardonner.
And we see God show you mercy.
Et vous verrez Dieu va vous faire miséricorde.
Amen.
Amen.
Almighty Father, we just want to thank you.
Père tout puissant, notre
we appreciate you because of your loving
compassion, Seigneur, pour ton amour et ta
Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for the word of God that has gone forth.
Nous te remercions pour la
parole. As many as have asked you for forgiveness.
Pour ceux qui t'ont demandé pardon.
For unnecessary fear of the unknown.
Pour la peur inutile de l'inconnu.
Father, please accept them in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, "Taste and see that the Lord is good."
La Bible dit que
Father, I have tasted of your goodness and your mercy.
Tasted de ta bonté, ta miséricorde.
Everyone that is asking for that same taste today,
tout celui qui demande ce
let them have experience of breakthrough in the name of Jesus. During this time of uncertainty,
en cet moment d'incertitude,
you promise you will keep us and our children.
Tu as promis de nous garder, nous et nos enfants.
Both spiritual children and my biological children.
Les enfants spirituels et aussi biologiques.
Father, please keep us in the name of Jesus.
Garde-nous au nom de Jésus.
Fulfill that promise in our life.
Accomplis cette promesse dans nos vies.
Let us have that confidence to go in and go out.
Que nous ayons cette confiance, cette assurance de sortir.
And let your name be glorified.
Et que ton nom soit glorifié.
Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Au nom puissant de Jésus, nous prions.
Let me hear better. Amen.
Amen.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let somebody shout a big hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I just want to make a quick announcement.
Je vais faire une annonce.
That by the grace of God, our Friday meeting is still going to be online. Our Bible study is going to be online.
Notre étude biblique sera en ligne.
By 7 p.m. on Friday.
À 19h.
Our night vigil will be cancelled.
Donc notre veille de nuit, la prière sera annulée.
And it's time for us to take our offering.
Et alors, les offrandes.
For the few people that are in the church,
pour ceux qui sont dans l'église,
you can give your offering.
Vous pouvez donner.
For those of you that are online,
pour ceux qui sont en ligne,
just go to our website.
Vous pouvez aller
www.rccgcatino.com.
Sur notre site web.
www.rccgcatino.com. And online giving.
Et vous pouvez donner.
And follow the instructions.
Et suivez les instructions.
And if this message has blessed you,
si ce message vous a béni,
you can go online and give us an email.
Vous pouvez aller en ligne.
You can send an email to us.
Vous pouvez nous envoyer un courrier.
And if you want to give your life to Jesus,
et si vous voulez donner votre vie à Christ,
or you have a prayer request,
vous avez une requête de prière,
please send us an email.
Veuillez nous envoyer un courriel.
God bless you.
Que Dieu vous bénisse.
In Jesus' name.
Au nom de Jésus.
The choir.
La chorale.
Lord, you are so good. Blessed be your name.
Oh,
Praise the Lord.
Oui, le Seigneur.
We'd like to thank everyone that has given.
Nous remercions toutes les personnes qui ont donné.
If you are connecting to us for the first time,
si c'est votre première fois d'être
connecté, please send an email to the church and we'll follow up.
S'il vous plaît, envoie un courriel à l'église et nous allons.
I think it's time for praise walk and prayer walk.
C'est le moment de montrer, démontrer la force de la prière et de la
louange.
Et l'assurance que nous vous donnons, c'est que vous êtes
sauvés. Aucun
fléau n'approchera de votre tente.
Please, shall we pray?
Prions.
Our Father and our God, we thank you for an opportunity to give to you today.
Seigneur, nous te remercions pour l'opportunité de te donner.
We exalt your holy name for your children, oh God,
nous
that have given.
Ton Seigneur pour tes enfants qui ont donné.
Those that have given in the church here right now.
Qui ont donné dans l'église ici.
And those that have given online.
Et ceux qui ont donné en ligne.
One thing we trust you for.
Une des choses que nous te.
Is croyons. That we know that those that put their trust in you shall not be put to shame.
Nous savons que ceux qui mettent leur confiance en toi les
feront. In times like this, oh God.
Dans ces temps, Seigneur.
I pray for every member of chapel.
Je prie pour chaque membre de chapelle.
You will never lack.
Tu vas jamais
manquer. You will never beg.
Tu vas jamais manquer.
You will not go hungry.
Tu ne vas pas
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Au nom puissant de Jésus.
Financially, oh God.
Financièrement, Seigneur.
You that can bring water out of the rock.
Toi qui peux faire jaillir l'eau.
You are the one that can bring money out of the fish.
De rocher, toi qui peux enlever l'argent de poisson.
Stand in the gap for everyone that has given and wish to give.
Non, je me mets entre les gens qui aimeraient donner et qui ne peuvent pas donner.
That financially you will promote us.
Et que financièrement tu
financially
vas nous
you will bless us.
Financièrement tu vas nous bénir.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Au nom puissant de Jésus.
We ask, oh God, that by the reason of this offering.
Nous te demandons qu'à cause de cette offrande, Seigneur.
Let each and every one of us be above financially.
Que toute personne soit au-dessus financièrement.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Au nom puissant de Jésus.
You will never lack. You will never beg. You will not go hungry. You will not be thirsty. The Lord will help you financially.
Le Seigneur va vous aider financièrement.
In times like this, God will make a way for you.
Dans les temps ainsi, le Seigneur va créer un chemin.
We ask, oh God, for your mercy.
Nous te demandons pour ta miséricorde.
That financially you will have mercy upon us.
Que financièrement que tu aies pitié.
And your name alone will be glorified.
Et que ton nom soit glorifié.
As we receive your mercy.
Pendant que nous recevons ta miséricorde,
we will spread the news.
Nous allons publier la parole.
That there is a God that is merciful.
Qu'il y a un Dieu qui est miséricordieux.
Father, let our land receive mercy.
Que notre terre reçoive la miséricorde.
Let this province receive mercy.
Que cette province reçoive ta
miséricorde. Let your children receive mercy.
Que tes enfants reçoivent ta miséricorde.
And in this new week, you will be compassionate unto us.
Et aie pitié de nous dans cette nouvelle semaine.
In this new week, your presence will go with us.
Que ta présence aille avec nous cette semaine.
Wherever we go, we ask for divine protection.
Partout où nous dirons que ta protection divine soit avec nous.
In our homes, we ask for divine provision.
Dans nos maisons, nous demandons que tu proviennes pour nous.
And we ask for divine guidance.
Et nous te demandons de nous guider divinement.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Dans le puissant de Jésus, nous
avons. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Dans le puissant de Jésus, nous avons.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Dans le puissant de Jésus, nous avons. Amen.
Please, shall we share the grace in fellowship?
Partageons ensemble la grâce.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. For we shall live, we shall not die. We shall live to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you and have a great week and be blessed in Jesus' name.
Que le Seigneur vous bénisse.
Please keep safe and it is well with you.
Soyez sains.
Praise the Lord. Let's stand for Jesus.
Praise the Lord.